everyone, it's your girl Shay here and I'm back with another video. And in this video, I'm talking about some news that came out this past weekend that Amazon has decided to end their TV subscription service, Anime Strike. Now, I know the biggest thing that went on regarding this service was that it was not included in the package if you were an Amazon Prime member. If you was an Amazon Prime member, you had to shell out about $159 a year to have both. And if you didn't have Amazon Prime, I think it was like 60 bucks a year or something like that. It was a pretty high cost. Also considering that a lot of anime fans also pay for Crunchyroll and Funimation to use their services, as well as Hulu, since Hulu also has anime on there as well. So what Amazon ended up doing is actually just including being able to watch anime series with your Amazon Prime membership. The reason why they did this, it seems, is because it was too much money. A lot of people did not want to spend the extra money to have access to Anime Strike if they were already an Amazon Prime member, and I am one of those. I actually use an Amazon Prime account, and to have to pay extra for Anime Strike, I was like, I'm not doing that. I'd rather just watch everything on Funimation or on Crunchyroll, which actually ended up being kind of difficult considering Amazon actually ended up getting a few hit shows that have came out for the past few seasons. One of them being Inuyashiki, which came out for, I believe, fall for 2017. And then there's also Scum's Wish that came out, I think, for the winter 2016 season as well, which made it difficult for those of us who wanted to watch those shows to be able to watch them because they weren't on anything else that we were actually able to watch, pretty much. Now, what does this mean for everyone else? What this means now that Amazon now includes anime episodes with their Amazon Prime membership, then now it's kind of worth it to get Amazon Prime. With Amazon Prime, you get free shipping, you also get one day shipping as well for products that you need really, really quick. But now you also have access to those anime TV subscription services, along with some other perks that you get with Amazon Prime. I think this was a great thing because, like many other people, like I said before, I didn't want to pay extra to be able to watch anime, and now we get to have access to a lot of the good shows, or a lot of shows that were very interesting to watch on other sites or other places besides just Crunchyroll and besides just Funimation. And I feel like this is kind of going to start happening considering that Crunchyroll and Funimation, with them combining their services a little bit, it actually also lowered the cost for you to be able to have Funimation service. So I feel like this probably might be an ongoing trend with seeing, you know, a lot of big name companies seeing that people want to watch anime and then lowering the cost so that they get more anime fans to be able to subscribe to their services. But what do you think now that Amazon has gotten rid of Anime Strike? Are you now going to get an Amazon Prime membership? Do you still not find it worth it to get an Amazon Prime membership? Do you use Amazon Prime? Do you use Amazon at all? I know I use it every now and then, but now do you deem it worthy? Let me know down in the comments below if you're now going to get Amazon Prime so you can be able to watch anime on Amazon Prime. Alright you guys, I'll see you guys next with another video. Hopefully, I hope you guys enjoy this one. So give this video a thumbs up and subscribe if you haven't already. Alright you guys, bye!